Nepotism. This might be the most overused word of 2020 after the word COVID in India. The death of the amazing Bollywood actor Sushant Singh Rajput has reopened that discussion about nepotism in cinema. Many were in support of nepotism, while others were criticizing the unfairness of the system on how it has made great actors lose out on several opportunities. Well, I don't know if nepotism is good or bad, but what I know is that nepotism exists everywhere. Even in what I consider to be the best film industry of India, the Malayalam film industry, or Bollywood as we fondly call it. But there is a small twist. On one hand, where the star kids of Bollywood are hated tremendously, the star kids of the Malayalam film industry are not at all hated. Like seriously, why? Are people hypocrites? Well, I'm pretty sure by the end of this video, you will definitely get the answer as we take a look back. Pranav Mohanlal, the son of the great actor Mohanlal, made his debut in Aadhi, written and directed by Jiddu Joseph and produced by his own home production Ashirwad Cinemas. He played the role of an aspiring young musician who accidentally got involved in a murder. The movie had a narrative that focused on his fluidity in action and studiously underplayed the young kid's acting skills or lack of it. The film became the highest earning film of that year, grossing over 500 million, and this was definitely a great start to his career. But on the other hand, back in 2012, Dulquer Salman, the son of the another superstar Mammootty, made his debut in Second Show. It tanked at the box office and charming screen presence of Dulquer was instantly noticed. He won the Filmfare Award for the best male debut for the same movie in 2012. From there on until now, Mammootty has kept himself away from his son's path and stardom in public. For almost a decade, they have successfully coexisted in the industry without ever allowing people to indulge in any comparisons between their choice of films or acting skills. So historically, like in any other field, as I told you earlier, nepotism exists in the Malayalam cinemas too. Prem Nazir's son Shanawaz made an impressive debut in Prema Geethangal but was unable to recreate his success despite starring in over 50 films. Sukumaran's sons Prithviraj and Indrajit might have got an easy entry, but they have to work for decades to earn a respected position today. Vinny Srinivasan, the eldest son of Srinivasan, made his debut as a singer in Kilichundan Mambaram. Then he tried acting, which did not find many takers, and finally found his niche in direction. Suresh Gopi's eldest son Gokul Suresh debuted in Muddugav, but he did not quite sparkle. Kalidas Jayaram, the son of Jayaram, was launched as a hero in the Tamil film, but he had repeated failures in the Malayalam film industry with movies like Poomaram and Mr. and Mrs. Rowdy. Other actors include Sudhir Karamana, Arjun Ashogan, Shane Nigam and Shammi Tilagan. The gender ratio of nepotism is predictably skewed. Daughters of actors, directors and technicians entering the industry is minimal, but there are definitely some exceptions. Now coming to the other side of the story, the outsiders. Malayalam cinema's longest standing superstars Mammootty and Mohanlal were outsiders with no background in films. Some of the other names in the business are Manju Warrier, Urvashi, Tilagan, Nedumudi Venu, Oduvil Unnikrishnan, Bharat Gopi, Suresh Gopi, Jayaram, Jayasurya, Murali, Biju Menon, Srinivasan, Nitya Menon, Rajisha Vijayan, Parvati Tiruvut, Nimisha Sajayan, Asif Ali, Suraj Venyaramud and many more. They had no legacy to back them up. Nivin Pauly, who entered the industry through auditions, recently completed 10 years, has got some of the biggest hits of Malayalam cinema to his name. Tovino Thomas, who entered as an assistant director and worked his way up. From 2016 to 2018, he has had a movie release every month, making it a subject of memes on social media. Malayalam cinema has seen star kids trying their luck in acting over the years, but to label it as nepotism would be far from reality, considering the success they have achieved. It is definitely an industry dominated by Mammootty and Mohanlal, and they will definitely continue to reign supreme. Malayalam film industry is the one film industry where the viewers accept the movies based on the concept, and at times the makers of the movie have got more brand value than the stars. In the past 10-12 years, Malayalam cinema has definitely seen few radical changes. The new wave has arrived, bringing along a fresh set of directors, writers, actors and technicians who did not belong to any cinema background. Cinema was evolving, content had taken a 360-degree turn, and superstar films were slowly becoming a distant memory. This also meant that there was space for aspiring actors coming from schools, theater groups, who earlier struggled to fit in a cinema, which only glorified larger-than-life heroes. A new culture of auditions, casting directors and workshops emerged, making the process more transparent. Earlier, Malayalam cinema was only restricted to Kerala's capital, Thiruvananthapuram. But the emergence of Kochi as a hub of cinema activity resulted in a gang of young talents who were determined to change the rules and the grammar of Malayalam cinema. A group from Maharaja's College, namely Anwar Rashid, Amal Neerad, Rajiv Ravi, and Ashik Abu, have risen quickly, and Vinish Srinivasan nurturing a young promising team of technicians, writers, and directors like Lejo Jose Pellicheri, Dilesh Putan, Zakaria, Basil Joseph, and Midu Manuel Thomas making their debut and floodgates opening. Filmmakers from every nook and corner of the state found a place to tell their stories, and out came movies like Maheshinte Pradhigaram, Angamali Diaries, and Sudan from Nigeria. A film like Unda would have been unthinkable 10 years ago. It had superstar Mammootty sharing equal space with nine other principal actors and not making a big deal of his stardom. Fahad Faisal, despite his lineage, is one of the most admired actors of the industry today. But his success is definitely the result of the collaborations he made with the new age directors. Of course, there is nepotism. But a more favorable question would be whether such family favoritism is so dominant as to stifle the Malayalam industry. And the answer lies in how you perceive the Malayalam cinema today. Has it become bolder in terms of themes? Has it thrown up great variety in filmmaking styles? And has it opened its doors to a wide range of talents? If the answer to all the three questions is yes, then there is no point about worrying of nepotism in the Malayalam cinema. Films in India were introduced as a medium to tell stories. But sadly, the face of Indian cinema, that is Bollywood, is slowly losing its charm. Bollywood today remains limited to a few families with some less talented actors creating trash. But the real gems of acting don't get the opportunity they deserve and they remain as nobody. From a normal person's perspective, nepotism is bad. But hating on a star kid just because he or she is born in a particular family, or making highly offensive content and bullying them online, or disliking their trailers and posting hate comments and messages is definitely not the way to stop nepotism. But from a commercial perspective, cinema at the end of the day is a business, and nobody does business to encounter losses. The star kids of the Malayalam film industry are least hated because they have proved their worth by their talent and their skills. The stardom which a star enjoys today is given to him by the audience. The success or failure of any movie totally depends on us people who watch the movie. And if there is no viewer, a film star is nothing but just another person walking on the road. So if you're not liking a star kid for his or her performance, simply stop watching them. Instead, invest your time on people who actually deserve, and that's when we discover the real gems. The Malayalam film industry has given so many iconic actors to the world, who have acted in so many evergreen and legendary movies. Some of the movies were released decades before we were born, and the people of this generation enjoy them to the core. And that's the reason why Malayalam film industry is the best film industry. And this was possible because Malayalis chose to watch the right films. The ones which had quality, the ones in which the actors had delivered their best on screen, and the ones which really deserve to be watched. And this clearly proves that Malayalis are discerning and overly critical, to put in place more filters for insiders than outsiders. True, superstar films will definitely coexist with realistic cinema, but in Malayalam cinema, it is clearly proven that only those with talent will definitely hold the test of time. Maybe the insiders will be given a long rope, but the audience will definitely keep their eyes on the finish line.